Someone Tell Nigerians, our very own comedy club, in specific the Luya mini series, comprising of Sospita, Shiminui, Makombora, and Matofali. I'm gonna top you guys up with Musambati. Is much better than all of your Afro cinemas, comprising of the Igwes, the Gedmans, the Ogas, and the Madams. Although in Kenya, Igwe means leopard, some animal that likes eating Nigerians, by the way. And Oga in Kenya means, we mean that by saying it's like taking shower. Someone need to tell you Nigerians, our football team came from Kenya to Nigeria. You gave us some funny ground to play around on. But eventually, we won the game. As in, seriously, you guys came back after 90 minutes. It's when that you scored your drawing goal. Your players were just, your eagles, by the way, were just scavenging in the field. But our boys were just shining. They're shining stars. Harambe stars. Harambe in Kiswahili means coming together. And that's what we did. And we made sure the eagles were scavenging. Someone tell Nigerians, I'm a farmer. We just had some cock crow. I don't breed bank. In that case, I'm talking about your robbers. Those fake robbers that you have. But then Nigeria is a disgrace to this world. It's only Nigeria whereby you get robbers. They put on bandanas, put on very big, funny black goggles, smoke bank, and fake your accent that you're Jamaican or something, then go rob a bank. Then the funny thing about it, by the way, when you go to rob the bank, you're the ones who are robbed, other than robbing the bank. Talk about Kenyan robbers. These guys are civilized. We carry M16s. Get the point? M16s. And when they come to the bank to rob, they don't beat people just like, you know, stupid people. They talk to people. They tell people, you know what? We came here, guys, to rob. This is our business. We're coming to rob you guys. So want you guys just to cooperate and give us everything that you have. You're looking for money and you're valuable. And the guys cooperate and give them what they have. And everybody lives in peace. Somebody needs to tell Nigerians that. Someone tell Nigeria. It's only Nigeria where you can't differentiate between a man and a woman because you all put dresses. How would I know a pregnant woman and a man who is putting on a dress? In Kenya, we don't do that. In fact, it's only two Kenyans I know. And I'm really suspecting if they're really Kenyans, by the way, who put on those clothes that you put on. I'm talking about Olirogo Manduli and some guy called, I think Miguna Miguna. When you guys talk of Akwe and Ukwe, we talk about our Nikobe and Mwala. Kenya, we are on top, my man. We gave America Obama. Superpower, right? We are the superpower. You all know what Obama did. I don't want to talk about it. We are feeling philanthropic enough starting from now. We're going to give you guys our Dida. Dida the teacher. Yeah, for free. Philanthropic. We're giving you guys Dida. We need to tell you guys something that you need to know, by the way. Your Mr. Ibu can't be compared to our Mr. Ibu. Our Mr. Ibu is a political figure. He has a party named after peace, Amani. You get the point? But your Mr. Ibu, troublesome. I believe that guy is drunkard, illiterate, insane. You know, the mouth and, you know, it's crazy. You can't compare your Mr. Ibu to our Mr. Ibu. Someone needs to tell Nigeria that. Someone tell Nigeria, it's only Kenya, in this world, by the way, whereby you have an election, we vote peacefully, everything we do peacefully. When there's something disputed, we go have post-election violence in the sites. We fought on Facebook. We fought on Twitter. Not like you guys when you keep on banning yourselves over there. We learned from our past, by the way. We are Kenyans. Someone needs to tell Nigerians. Someone tell Nigerians, by the way. We are going to bring our rappers. I'm going to start with Bamboo. Octopizzo, baby. Number nine. I'm going to top up that with Kolo, King Warap. Then I think I'm going to add, let me talk about a bus. And I think I'll tag myself along. Then you bring your rappers, of which I don't even remember. I don't know your rappers. I only know guys from Nigeria seeing things that you don't even hear. Kenya is a country comprised of 42 tribes, by the way. We have different accents. That's 42 accents. Have you ever heard us speaking those funny accents? We speak Queen's English. We don't speak Pidgin English like yours. That's the reason you are disgraced to this continent because of your funny language that you speak around, going around here, pretending that you can speak of what you speak. Nigerian. By the way, Nigerian crafts have their own landing points. Kenyan crafts have airports. We land on the airport, a port in the air. That's Kenya for you. Someone need to tell Nigeria. And before I go, I want to tell you guys this. I want to know why is Mr. Flavor always topless. Why can't you give your artists names rather than give them mathematical names? You know, B square, you know, bracket. Can't you get something else to call these guys? Sincerely speaking, someone needs to tell Nigeria. Somebody tell Nigeria, our ladies put on wigs when they sleep. By the way, they just put it for fun. And if you think I'm lying, go watch Comedy Club. Our ladies put on wigs for fun. But what do our ladies do? They put on wigs to differentiate them between men and women, because now you guys are so like, okay, we don't know the difference between a man and a woman. Somebody needs to tell Nigeria. You Nigerians are very crazy in a way that when you're acting in a movie, the sex parts look like guys are fighting. What are people, are you people? Someone needs to tell Nigeria. You don't walk naked to show somebody that you're cursing somebody. In Kenya, we don't do that. Our witchcraft is so civilized by the way in a way that we did on the internet. By the way, whatever I've just said, I know I've really messed some of you guys. And if you feel like I've done something wrong by telling you what I've said, go hang yourself.